Welcome to part 3 of UnityConnect training. Let's take a tour of the UnityConnect interface. Software functionality is organized with a menu bar. This is the transformer selector. Most users only have one transformer, so they will not use it. However, back to our garage car analogy from part 1, some customers have multiple custom transformers. The transformer selector allows them to switch from car to car. The date selectors allow users to control the range of data that is transformed. There are shortcut buttons for common tasks. Some customers use the watch button. It puts UnityConnect in an autopilot-like mode. It automatically transforms new QC data and alerts the user if additional configuration is needed. See the reference guide for more detail on watching. The stop button turns off the watch mode. If not using the watch functionality, the go button is used to manually transform a QC data file. The configure button allows the user to alter the transformer's configuration. We'll cover this in depth during the following video. If not configured for automatic import, the import button allows the user to manually import data after it's been transformed. In general, UnityConnect runs on autopilot, automatically processing your QC data without any effort on your part. However, when UnityConnect detects a new instrument, control, lot number, or test, you'll need to configure the new item and possibly reprocess your data. The notes provide information about what UnityConnect is doing. The Help menu offers help related to UnityConnect. Back to our garage car analogy. This is information related to the garage. It does not contain specifics related to the transformers. We'll look at that in a moment. Continue your training by viewing Part 4.